Paul Ellering and Larry Zbyszko have joined me.
Well, you know, I know Buzz and Paul got something to say. I've got something to say, too. And where this Mr. Two is, I'm telling you, I'm going to take my belt. I don't care where, but I tell you, it's a matter of time, and time's running out for Mr. Two. I'm not playing no more games.
Ain't nobody's playing no games. I ain't playing no games with Piper. I ain't playing no games with Rant. I ain't playing no games with Sawyer. I ain't playing no games with you. I ain't playing no games with nobody. I'm sick and I'm tired of all these people out here thinking they're somebody and not being nobody. You know as well as I do, Gordon Soley, that when I stand out here, the whole building shakes. When I stand out here, everybody listens, because I'm the man, dog. I am the man that makes World Championship Wrestling what it is today.
Oh, indeed. I'll tell you what, sir. There's somebody that I understand you'd rather not have anything to do with.
I'm too scared of nobody.
I know you're not afraid of
anybody. I ain't scared of nobody.
I understand that, but let's listen right now to some very interesting comments from a man who certainly isn't afraid of anybody either.
No.
He's off the wall. Dick Slater's off the wall. But here are some words from Roddy Piper.
Oh, you go.
How you doing, Sawyer? Mad dog. Well, let's took the band-aids off the noggin here, because I wanted to know that it has been one of the tougher matches I ever had in my life. Didn't expect Precious Paul out there, although I did just fine, didn't I? Precious Paul. All of a sudden, I have these folks that want to be jumping in and jumping on me. Precious Paul, some fella that's supposed to be a ladies' man, nice blonde hair. Too bad he had to go and dye the roots black like that. Huh? Gets up in the morning, puts his socks on, puts his Fruit of the Loom underwear on, and Fruit of the Loom guys fall over laughing. Puts his high heel sneakers on, goes out and wants to jump in the ring on RP. Heard a lot of things. Heard Gary Hart, him and the great Kabuki. Oh, we're very well acquainted. Gary Hart, the Elmer Fudd of wrestling, comes and gives himself a nice shine every morning, says, I've been looking for Roddy Piper. Roddy Piper didn't have enough ammunition. I have never, ever seen the bottom of my pale ammunition. Whole bunch of people talking all kinds of stuff, you see. But the problem is, every time I come down to Atlanta, what they want to do is, after I finish fighting, they say, whoa, wait a second. Whoa, who's this guy? Get him out of here. He's too much trouble. But you see, when you're handling people like this, if you want some troubleshooters to come in down there and take care of commotion, like the Mad Dog, like Precious Paul, like Gary Hart, like the great Kabuki, then you're going to have some crazy people come down and do it. So it's simple as this. I want to come back. I'm asking the people, don't let them bar me. They're not considering it now. They're just afraid of me. They're just trying to avoid me. I'm telling you one thing, brother. When it comes to the Omni, when it comes to Atlanta, when it comes to Chicago, when it comes to any place, you need someone to take care of trouble. You're looking at a 45 single action jack. When you're looking at someone, the boys is back in town, and we's back to stay.
Well, Roddy Piper wants back.
Oh, yes. I hear a drip, and it's not a faucet. It's you, Roddy Piper.
Rich! Tonight, just a little bit away, a cage match. I'm like a dog behind the cage. Huntington, West Virginia, it's you and me. Slater, Ridge, Piper, Wally, it goes on. And in the Omni, Zbyszko, take care of two. I'll be watching. I'll be there.
I'm going to retire, Mr. Two in the Omni. I'm going to take back the belt. And we're not playing no more games with nobody. Not in Huntington tonight against Garvin. Not in the Omni against Mr. Two. Everybody is fighting a big one now, baby. We'll be right back.